alter table from SQL raw and migrations. In the previous tutorials, we have learned CRUD operations for a simple form. If you remember, this is the form that we used in our previous tutorials. This is the form that we used. This form had one input text. There was only one input text field and there was the save button for submit. This whole form was connected to the model class called product. The model was called product and the product model, it was the backing for this whole form. This product had two properties. One property was ID. ID, this was auto-generated and we called it as our primary key. The second property was called name. This name property was connected to this input text. The data in the input text was bound to the name property and this name property was also connected to the database. This name property was connected to a column called name of a table called product in our database. This is the situation that stands as of now. Now today let us suppose we have to add more form elements to this form. What other changes would be required and how they would be done? This is the topic of discussion today. Suppose we have to add more radio buttons. Suppose we have to add a drop-down also. Suppose we have to add a checkbox also. That is, we have to add one property, two property, three. We have to add three more properties. We will learn how to do this. Where will the changes be required? What are the steps required? This diagram will explain the whole story to you. This is the form. This is the product model class. And this is the database table called product. If we add any fields to this, corresponding properties will be added here also for the matching data types. And corresponding columns for matching data types will be added to the product table also. Let us start by adding the product model class. Come to the Solution Explorer. This is the Solution Explorer for our project. This is the project. This is the models folder. And find the class called file called product.cs. Double click this file to open your class product. This is the class. This is the product model class. Inside this class, we already have ID for int, the primary key property, and we already have been using the string name property. These are already there. Let us begin by adding additional properties. One property that we will be adding is public bool is active getSet. This property will be connected to our checkbox on our form. This is very easy to understand. The second property is item quality. This property will be used to generate the radio button list for us. This property, if you can see, is dependent on a enumeration called quality. This enumeration has been created here and superior, zero, inferior, normal. These values they have been put into this enumeration. It will help me generate three radio buttons. Why I have used enumeration? Enumeration will help me write more readable .NET code, first thing. The second thing is that these radio buttons I will generate by using a for each loop on the enumeration items. If I were to add more items to this, more radio buttons will automatically get generated. So this is good from maintenance point of view also. So this is the second property that we are adding. This is the first additional property. Then we have to add a property for the dropdown also. Item location is the property that we will be adding for the dropdown list. This property is also based on an enumeration called location. The location has three items and three items will appear in our dropdown. The reasons for using enumeration are exactly the same, more readability and maintenance. Add more locations and they will appear here automatically. Now, This all is the addition of properties to your model class. We have to take care of one more thing. This enumeration called quality, this enumeration called location, this is understood by your .NET code, but not by database. The database understands numeric, integer, varchar, text and all that, but it doesn't understand your .NET enumerations. So we will have to apply conversions. We will have to specify the rules for conversion. When the data goes from quality to database, it should go as int. And when it comes from database, the int should change to quality so that your .NET code can understand it. Let us see how we can do that. Come to the project context. This project context or DB context we have been using already. This is the empty constructor already discussed. This is the DB set already done. On model creating, we had one statement already. This statement was model builder entity product to table product. This statement was already there. It gave the name product to our table. We will use this product table for our SQL scripts. Okay. This statement, let us read it. This is added. Model binder entity product. The product model has a property called item quality. This item quality has a conversion called int. This is the rule for conversion from product to int, from item quality to int. Similarly, we have written the second rule for item location to string. In our database, we will call this column by integer or number and this column by varchar or text. These rules, I have used it as int, I have used it as string. I could have written string here, int here. I have not applied any mind to it. I have simply used two different data types to help you understand that we can apply these sorts of conversions. Your actual project should determine what exact conversion you need. So after modifying your product model and after this first step, our next step would be the modification of your database. We will have to add three columns to the product table of our database. So the question is how to modify the database. One method is to use the .NET CLI or .NET Core command line tools that are made available by the EF Core. These are ready-made tools that are available. They will help you generate all the required database SQL scripts. Those scripts also will be run automatically by these tools. This is the web page that you can visit to have more information on that. But I will not be using this technique. I will be running the SQL commands and scripts directly. I will run them directly to make my modifications. I personally like this method because it allows me to fine-tune the whole process. If you use the previous method, there are many things that go behind the curtains. In that case, you have very less control. Chances of unintended side effects, those all things are always there. So it is always better to run the SQL commands and scripts directly on your database. Let us see how we do that. Come to your Solution Explorer, find your project, and open the startup.cs file for this. Let us open and modify the startup.cs file. This is the startup.cs class that opens, file that opens, and this is the startup class that we are going to modify. This startup class has configure services. We have already done this, no change required. Then we have the second method called configure. This was already there, and this part of the code, if you remember, this we used for creating the database. We obtained the services context and from the we obtained the service provider. From that we got the context, and context was used to ensure created. The database was created through this code. Today we have to add the additional code for alteration. The first, we will have to run the SQL scripts directly, the SQL commands directly. The command, first command is select star from Pragma table info product where name is active. Basically, this is a SQLite SQL statement that will help me determine if my product table, it contains a column called is active. If it contains this column, that means it is already modified. So we will not run any code. If it doesn't contain this column, we will add additional columns to our database. Let us see how. This is the command string and context.products.fromsqlraw. This is the function you will need. This is available on the products context from sqlraw.count. When this statement is run, you get the number of rows. This we store in I. If no row is found, if zero, then we will run this code. Otherwise, nothing is done. We just exit it. So how to add more columns? Create a command alter table product add column is active boolean default false. We will run on the database context.database.executeSQLRAW. Async is not required here. .executeSQLRAW. When this query is run, this is active column will get added to the product table. After that, we will add a column for item quality, the same thing. Add a column for item location, the same thing. This is how your database can be modified by using simple directly executed SQL statements. Go through this whole to understand what I have done. But my suggestion here is, don't write all this code inside your this configure method. This is actually the wrong place. But I had to teach you, so I have done it. This whole code should preferably be put inside a separate file with proper history notes, comments, and this code should actually be run from the administrative panel of your website. So that all you can decide later on. The other part is already there. This doesn't require anything. You can obtain the source code from me to understand this whole thing if you are unable to do it. But let us now run the project. We can assume that the changes have succeeded if it runs without errors. If you get any exception, that means something has gone wrong. You will have to locate the error and all that. In the next tutorial, we shall complete the form to add the radio buttons, checkboxes, and the drop down. Thank you.